Hello friends, today we are going to study the problems on CST element. Earlier also we have seen many problems. Today we are going to study the analysis of plate. Okay, so we will see this problem. Find the nodal displacement and elemental stresses for the two dimensional loads, that is C15 plate as shown in figure. So assume plane stress condition with thickness that is t is equal to 10 mm and modulus of elasticity given is equal to 2.080 into 10 to the power 5 newton per mm square, and Poisson's ratio is also given, mu is equal to 0.32, and also it is given in the problem that body force is neglected in comparison with the external force. Okay, so so now we will just find the free body diagram of the same plate. Okay, as it is a rectangular plate having 150 by 100 mm dimensions, which is fixed at two points. Okay, and having roller support at one point. Okay, so now we will just find the forces, deflection acting on it. So as we are dealing with constant strain triangular element, we will discretize this plate into elements as shown in figure. We will just discretize by diagonally, and we will give numbers 1 and 2 elements. So two elements we have considered over here, and at node number 1 there will be two deflections, that is in x direction, that is a u1, in y direction v1. At node number 2 the deflection is u2 v2. At node number 3 deflection is u3 v3, and at node number 4 deflection is u4 v4. And now we will see what are the elements. First element we will consider, that is element number 1, and we will just note that at node number 1 the coordinates will be x1 y1, at node number 2 the coordinates will be x2 y2, at node number 3 the coordinates will be x3 y3. So accordingly we will just consider node number 1 as a origin point, and accordingly we will find the values, or what we can say, coordinates of the nodes. Okay, so for element number 1, nodal displacements are u1 v1, u2 v2, u3 v3. Okay, so we are just considering node number 1 as a origin, and you can see over here the values of x1 y1, x2 y2, x3 y3, which is from the given diagram. And now for finding stiffness matrix K, we know that you have to just find matrix B transpose D matrix and B matrix into area into thickness. Okay, so this formula we have already used in many problems. So now we will just find E. E is what? E is the area of triangular element. So how we can find this area? We know that E is equal to 1 by 2 in matrix 1 x1 y1, 1 x2 y2, 1 x3 y3. So by putting the values and finding the determinant, we got the value of a area is equal to 7500 mm square. And now we will go further for the strain displacement matrix. So what is strain displacement matrix? It is just it is given over here. B is equal to 1 by 2a in matrix beta 1 0, beta 2 0, beta 3 0, 0 gamma 1 0, gamma 2 0, gamma 3 gamma 1 beta 1, gamma 2 beta 2, gamma 3 beta 3. So how to find this beta and gamma? Yesterday's lecture, in the extra lectures we have seen it. So it is all dependent on the coordinates x and y. So by putting all the values, we will get this value of b, and we can directly transpose this b matrix to get the beta b transpose. So next we will find the D matrix, that is stress strain relationship matrix, and which is for the plane stress problem. Okay, for plane stress problem, D is equal to E by 1 minus mu square. Here mu is Poisson's ratio, which is given in the problem already. So E upon 1 minus mu square in matrix 1 mu 0 mu 1 0 0 0 1 minus mu by 2. So just put mu is equal to 0.32, which is given in the problem, and we will get the value of D. So we have all the values which is necessary to find stiffness matrix. So K is equal to B transpose D B A into T. So all the values which are in multiplication we have combined over here, that is 0.0033 into 0.0033 into 2.3173 into 10 to the power 3, and area is equal to 7500 into thickness 10. So this is bit transpose minus 2 0000 minus 2 0. Oh, sorry, 2 0 minus 3 0 minus 3 2 0 0 3 and 0 3 0. Okay, it is 6 by 3 matrix. Then D matrix, it is 1 0.32 0 0.32 1 0 0 0 0.34, which is 3 by 3 matrix. It is in multiplication with B matrix, that is minus 2 0 2 0 0 0 0 0 0 minus 3 0 3 0 minus 2 minus 3 2 3 0, which is 3 by 6 matrix. So first we will multiply the first two matrices, that is B transpose and D matrix. So if we will find the multiplication of these two, we will get 6 by 3 matrix, and the resultant matrix will be multiplied with this B matrix. Okay, so 6 by 3 matrix into 3 by 6 matrix, so we will get the 6 by 6 matrix as a result of this. Okay, so K1 is equal to resultant matrix here is given over here, which is 6 by 6 matrix. Okay, so similarly for element number 2, same procedure we will find, same as we have adapted for element number 1, and we will get the value of stiffness matrix for element number 2. Okay, so using these two matrices, we will just find the global stiffness matrix for further calculations. Okay, so in the general finite element equation, we know that F is equal to K into U. So where F is equal to force matrix, that is Fx1, Fy1, Fx2, Fy2, Fx3, Fy3, Fx4, Fy4, which is a vertical force vector. So applying the boundary conditions, we will get at node number 1 the values of deflection, that is u1 v1, and at node number 4 it is also fixed point, so that u4 v4 all the values will be equal to 0, because at fixed point there will be no deflection. So v2 at node number 2, the vertical deflection will be 0 because there is a normal reaction because roller support is there. So v2 will be also equal to 0. So u2 you have to find, and fy3, that is force which is acting at node number 3 in vertically downward direction, so that it is minus 500 into 10 to the power 3 newton. So after applying the elimination method, so the row number 1, 2, 4, 7, 8, row number 1, 2, 4, 7, 8, and column number 1, 2, 4, 7, 8, that will be eliminated, and only this values, these values will be remaining over here, which are corresponding to u2, u3, v3. Okay, only these values you have to calculate. No need to calculate full global stiffness matrix. We can use this shortcut method wisely to save our problem in the final examination. So with the help of this equation, there are three unknowns, that is u2, u3 and v3. So we will easily find by using the simultaneous equations. U2 is equal to 0.09041 mm, U3 is equal to 0.03919 mm, and V3 is equal to -0.26999 mm. So what we have got is, depend on this, we will find the stress in element number 1. So we know that for finding stress, sigma is equal to matrix D matrix B into U. So all the values we have with us. So by calculating it, we will get the values of sigma x, sigma y, and tau x y, that is shear stress. And similarly for stresses in element number 2, we will use the same formula, that is sigma is equal to D into B into U, and we will get the values of sigma x, sigma y, and tau x y for element number 2 respectively. So thank you very much.